From Wall Street to Silicon Valley, Michelle Sun has seen the gender disparity in both finance and technology firsthand. She wants to empower the next generation, so she founded First Code Academy, which reaches more than 10,000 students in multiple cities around the world. I'm sitting down with Michelle today to discuss her entrepreneurial story, being a woman in the tech space, and how to increase gender equality in this industry. Michelle, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Sure. You know, now we do know that women are underrepresented in the tech industry. I'm curious, you know, what's the boy-girl ratio at your coding academy?
Yeah, you know, it's interesting too when I look around the classrooms, and when we look at the age group of 6 to 12 years old, the gender ratio is pretty balanced, 50-50 boys and girls. And somehow once it hit around 12 years old, the girls just disappear and there's like all boys in the classrooms and sometimes one or two girls.
Ah, so the gender divide starts pretty early.
Pretty early.
Why do you think that's the case?
Yeah, I mean, when we speak to the parents and some of our students, the girls sometimes get back to us and say, you know, I want to do something more girly. And
more girly.
Coding doesn't feel like something too girly, and I want to be with my girlfriends. And that's sometimes the reason why they turn away from starting to learn coding at the age of 12 or above.
So it's very much a part of the culture, isn't it? I mean, even in the, you have young girls saying, I don't want to do it, it's not girly enough. But when you look at the industry, the tech industry, there is, parts of it are infamous for having a bit of a bro culture, isn't it? How do we begin to change that? It's been ingrained for so many years.
Yeah, I think one of the steps that we should take is really to be aware of it as an industry and talk more about the behavior that can undermine minorities in the industry and start to encourage more of a discussion and to talk about these issues more openly.
You left a career in finance to move to the world of tech. Your first startup failed, and yet you went at it. What made you really so determined to create a space for yourself in the tech industry?
Yeah, so I would say my first job in finance was actually what planted my seed in wanting to go into the tech industry. I was an equity research analyst at Goldman, and where I went to visit multiple companies and understanding how tech companies actually change so many people's lives through their apps, their websites. And yeah, so even though my first startup failed miserably, I still wanted to go at it. And I'm thankful for the experience.
You know, was it tough for you to get funding, for example, or to get access to the resources you needed to start your own company? And do you think, was it harder because A, you're young, B, you're a woman in the tech space?
It was incredibly tough. Starting a company is like, you know, kind of swimming in open water, not knowing what's around and learning to swim at the same time. And I do think that as a minority, there is some sort of additional friction. And at the same time, what I've learned to tell myself more in the journey is that, you know what, it's tough for everyone. Even if I'm a male, you know, in my 40s, it's still tough. And so being a female back in the days in my 20s, I just need to go at it and solve the problem as it goes and approach it in a more objective manner.
Half the problem, it seems, is the lack of mentors, the lack of role models in the tech industry when it comes to successful women in this space. I mean, there are some, and you are one of them, especially in Asia. What kind of role model do you think you are for women who want a career in tech?
Yeah, I try to live by my values, and I feel that, you know, to blaze our own path and be persistent and, you know, seek out resources and be resourceful.
Great. Okay, thanks very much, Michelle, and we wish you good luck in empowering the next generation and to creating more role models, more women role models in the tech industry.
Thank you.
Thanks so much. That's Michelle Sun, the founder of First Code Academy and a passionate advocate for gender equality in the tech space.